أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
سورة القارعة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. القارعة، ما القارعة؟ وما أدراك ما القارعة؟ Some of the brothers must have recalled one more surah starts in this way. الحاقة، ما الحاقة؟ وما أدراك ما الحاقة؟ القارعة، that suddenly striking calamity. ما القارعة؟ What is that suddenly striking calamity? وما أدراك ما القارعة؟ And what will make you realize what that suddenly striking calamity is? يَوْمَ يَكُونُ النَّاسُ كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَبْسُوسِ. The scene of As-Sa'ah, it has come so many times in the Makki surahs. The day when mankind shall be like scattered moths. وَتَكُونُ الْجِبَالُ كَالْعِهْنِ الْمَنْفُوشِ. And the mountains shall be like carded wool. فَأَمَّا مَنْ سَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ. Then as for him whose balances of good deeds are heavy, فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ, he shall be in a well-pleasing life. اللهم ربنا اجعلنا منهم. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ. And as for those whose balance of good deeds are light, فَأُمَّهُ هَاوِيَةٍ, then the bottomless pit of hell will be like mother to them. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ. And what will make you realize what that is? نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ, a fire blazing. سورة التكاثر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ. O mankind, your rivalry for competition for amassing riches makes you unmindful. You want more, 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 more wealth, more riches, and you are busy in this, you are lost in this, and you remain unmindful of the real facts of life, what is going to happen, what is going to happen to you on the day of judgment. حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرِ, until you reach the graves. كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. No. But then you shall come to know, you shall realize what were the realities. ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. And again, then you shall come to realize and you will know. كَلَّا لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عِلْمَ الْيَقِينَ. Would that you knew with knowledge of certainty. لَتَرَبُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ, you shall certainly see the hellfire. ثُمَّ لَتَرَبُنَّهَا عَيْنَ الْيَقِينَ, and then you shall see it with the eye of certainty. Now these two words which have appeared here, ilmu al-yaqeen, عَيْنُ الْيَقِينَ, there are two stages of knowledge, rather three. Ilmu al-yaqeen, you know something by inferring, by some logical conclusions. This is ilm al-yaqeen. When you see it, this is ayn al-yaqeen. For example, if there is smoke rising, by ilm al-yaqeen you come to know there is a fire. You have not seen the fire, but you have inferred, because there is smoke going up, so there must be fire. But when you see the fire, now this is عَيْنُ الْيَقِينِ. There is a third term used in Quran twice, حَقُّ الْيَقِينِ. Although this has not been used in that sense, but some of the scholars count them, that this is the third and final level of the knowledge, haqqul yaqeen. When you put your hand in that fire and it burns, now you have the real conviction this is fire. But when you are seeing the fire, maybe, that this is some illusion. So, maybe some hallucinations. Even through senses, the knowledge that you get, you know, that can be wrong. So, ilmul yaqeen, aynul yaqeen, haqqul yaqeen. For the Quran, you know, in Surah Al-Waqi'ah and then in Surah Al-Haqqah, إِنَّهُ لَحَقُّ الْيَقِينِ. This word has appeared for Quran. ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. Then on that day you will be questioned concerning the worldly blessings that we have given you. We gave you this and this and this and this. What did you do? There is a hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, لَن تَزُولَ قَدَمَ ابْنِ آدَمَ حَتَّى يُسْأَلَ عَنْ خَمْسٍ. No human being will be able to go away when he will be made to stand before the Lord for that accountability unless he is questioned about five things. عَنْ عُمُرِهِ فِي مَا أَفْنَى. Regarding his age, where did you spend it? In what business? What occupation? What were you doing? وَعَنْ شَبَابِهِ فِي مَا أَفْنَى. Especially the youth, the youthful, you know, when there are energies, you know. In what condition did you pass that period of the life? وَعَنْ مَالِهِ مِنْ أَنَكْ تَصَبَهُ وَفِي مَا أَنْفَقَهُ. About the wealth, from where did you get it? Through permissible means or haram means, forbidden means? Where did you spend it? In the correct way, for the needy, for the deen of Allah, for your, you know, lawful rights of your body, of your children, or in luxuries, to show off your wealth, tabzir. And finally, وَعَمَّا عَمِلَ فِي مَا عَلِمَ. How much did you practice what you learned? You went on learning, 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 learning. You accumulated the knowledge of a library in the cells of your brain, but you are not practicing it. Then this knowledge will be used as a witness against you. Al-Qur'an hujjatun laka aw alayka. This Qur'an is either a guide for you or against you, a witness against you. Oh Allah, he read me. But then, even then, he did not practice me. ثُمَّ لَتُسَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. اللَّهُمَّ حَاسِبْنَا حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. Now the most profound surah of Quran, one of the smallest surahs, Surah Al-Asr, consisting of three ayat. And there are three surahs consisting of three ayat. No surah of two ayat. The least number is three. Suratul Asr, Suratul Kausar, Suratul Nasr. Three surahs. And this is the most profound, according to Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi. لَوْ تَدَبَّرَ النَّاسُ هَذِهِ السُّورَةِ لَوَسِعَتْهُمْ. If people ponder only over this surah, this will suffice to guide them. In another saying he says, لَوْلَمْ يُنَزَّلْ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ سِوَاهَا لَكَفَتِ النَّاسِ. If nothing was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam except this surah would have been sufficient for the guidance of humanity. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وَالْعَصْرِ. By the fleeting time, the time which is running, 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 it's going. And this is only capital you have. And like ice, it is melting. If you don't sell your ice, it will melt away. So by this time, what is that psalm of life, that poem? Art is long and time is fleeting. And our hearts, though stout and brave, still like muffled drums are beating funeral marches to the grave. With every beating of the heart, we are coming closer and closer, step by step, to our graves. Just like if the dead body of a general is taken to the grave, you know, there is the beating of the drum. With each beating of the drum, this funeral is progressing. So, غافل تجھے گھڑیال یہ دیتا ہے منا دی گردوں نے گھڑی عمر کی ایک اور گھٹا دی. When the clock rings, 11, one more hour has been diminished from your life. One more hour gone. Don't say that your life is increasing. Every hour your life is decreasing. وَالْعَصْرُ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. All mankind is doomed. To be doomed is the general rule. To be saved is an exception. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. All mankind. That is why Imam Razi says, اعلم أن هذه الآية فيها وعيد شديد لأن الله تعالى حكم بالخسار على جميع الناس إلا من كان آتيا بهذه الأشياء الأربعة وهي الإيمان والعمل الصالح والتواصي بالحق والتواصي بالصبر أن دل ذلك أن النجاة معلقة بمجموع هذه الأشياء. There is a very big threat in this surah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided that all human beings will be doomed, thrown into the hell, except those who fulfill four conditions. And this is decisive to say that the salvation on the day of judgment depends upon fulfilling the four, all the four conditions. Now when I started my work, this Dars of Suratul Asr was the starting point. And the selected course of study that I have edited, the starting point is Suratul Asr. I have written also, so I can't go into detail at this time. All men, all human beings are doomed except illa lazeen amanu, except those who have faith, real faith, conviction, iman. Wa'amil salihat, and they did good deeds. And tawasa bil haq, they exhorted each other to whatever is correct and just. Tawasa bil sabr, and exhorted each other to perseverance and steadfastness. May Allah give us the courage to fulfill all these four prerequisites of salvation. Suratul Humazah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Now this surah depicts a character. When somebody turns away from Allah, is not mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't think that he will be resurrected and he will have to answer his deeds, then his moral character definitely sinks down, bottom. And this is the picture. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. Woe to every slanderer, defamer. This is what interests them most. Slanders and defaming people. The mean activity. الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدًا. Number two, who amassed wealth and kept on counting it, seeing the balance sheet every year, oh, now, these are my assets, and this much I have and own. يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ. He thinks that his wealth will make him live forever. Now what does it mean? People have used their wealth in order to make their name at least. They know we shall die, but my name should remain. These big monuments, these Ahram-e-Misr, why? This is the urge to continue, if not physically, to continue living in the memory of the people. I recall, you know, a very beautiful quotation. Calm and self-possessed, still and resolute, the pyramids echo unto eternity. The defiant cry of man's will to survive and conquer the storms of time. Man wants to survive and conquer the storms of time. That is why he has built such a high pyramid for himself. Kalla, no, not at all. La yumbazanna fil hutama. He'll be thrown in the hutama. And what is that hutama? Wa ma adraka mal hutama. How will you come to know what is that hutama? Narullahi al-muqada. It's the fire of Allah kindled by Him. And don't think it's like the fire of this world. Allati tattaliu alal afida. Which will mount straight on the hearts of the people. We have today the, what they call the therapies, you know, the heat passing through the skin. Skin doesn't feel the heat, it goes to the muscles under. In the same way, fire, which is not affecting your body, straightly attacking your heart. That will be the quality of that fire. Allati tattaliu ala al-afida, bounce over the hearts. Innaha alayhi mursada. And then it will be closed upon them, vaulted upon. Fi amadim mumaddada. In outstretched columns. Azanallahu minh. Now the rest of these surahs mainly deal with certain aspects of the early period of the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. First of all, Suratul Fil, the very famous incident that took place. And that was the year when Muhammad was born, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aamul Vilada, it was 570 or 571 Christian era. What happened? At that time in Yemen was governed by the Abyssinians. And from the king of Abyssinia, there was a governor, Abraha, in Yemen. These were Christian, these people. They were under the Roman Empire. So this person became very envious of Kaaba, that people from all corners of Arabia go to Kaaba to pay pilgrimage. So he built a very high cathedral so that people should come here. But no Arab came there. They kept going to Kaaba. So in fury and anger, he decided, I'll destroy Kaaba, demolish it, raise it to ground. So he proceeded with a very big army, which had some elephants also. He himself was mounted on an elephant. Now this army came from Yemen till Makkah. Nobody in the way could check them. It was a very big army. And the elephants for these people of Arabia, something new, what is it? So frightened like anything. Then he, you know, stayed outside Makkah and sent a person to Abdul Muttalib, the grandfather of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He was the chief of Makkah. And he said that we have not come to fight you, only we want to demolish this house. The answer Abdul Muttalib gave was, also we can't fight you. We can't resist you, we know. As for this house, this belongs to Allah. If He wishes, He will save it. And then he requested for his 200 camels that the army people of Abraha had looted and plundered, which belonged to Abdul Muttalib. And Abraha said, oh, I have come to destroy your sanctuary. And you are more mindful of these camels of yours. He said, I own the camels. So I'm thinking about them. I don't own this house. This house is owned by someone else. He will take care of it. So when they attacked, what happened? أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ. Have you not seen how your Lord dealt with the companions of the elephant, the army accompanied by elephants? When it was coming forward, at a certain stage, the elephants sat on which Abraha was sitting. And they tried everything to goad it, but it didn't move. Then, you know, swarms of small birds appeared from the site of the Red Sea. And they had very small stones made of baked clay in their beaks and feet, and they threw them. And these small pellets, they acted as bullets. Most of the army destroyed. And whosoever could have an escape on way back, there was, you know, an epidemic broke out of smallpox, of measles, pustules, all over the body. And Abraha and all the people, they perished. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved his house. أَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ قَيْدَهُمْ فِي تَدْلِيلٍ. Did he not make their plan go astray? وَأَرْسَلَ عَلَيْهِمْ طَيْرًا أَبَابِيلَ. And he sent against them swarms of birds, flights and flocks of birds. تَرْمِيهِمْ بِهِجَارَةٍ مِّن سِجِّيلٍ. Striking them with the stones of baked clay. فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَّأْكُولٍ. And thus he made them like the straw which has been eaten up. Surah Al-Quraysh, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Now these are the conditions of the people of Makkah and around it. First of all, their economic backbone or lifeline was trading. They became the link in the East-West trade. I've explained many times regarding the nation of Saba also. Previously, the people of Yemen, they were the proprietors of this trade. But after the flood of Harim, they were destroyed. So now this trade came in the hands of the Quraysh. All the merchandise from eastern islands, India, China, it used to come on the ships and boats and unload it at the coast of Yemen. And all the merchandise from Europe came to the coast of Syria, Palestine. Now, because there was no Suez Canal, and that, you know, round the Cape of Good Hope, that route had to be discovered about 800 years later, 1498. So, now, between these two points, caravans going there, coming down, going up, to the north, to the south, and this way they became the link, inevitable link in the East-West trade. And they got the monopoly. Why? No caravan could pass without being looted and attacked, except the caravan of the Quraysh. Why? They were the custodians of Kaaba. And you know the idols of all the tribes, their gods, they were placed in Kaaba. So to say, they were hostages with the Quraysh. How could they loot the caravan of Quraysh? So they traveled without any fear. So this was the basis of their prosperity. The Ilafi Quraysh. To make Quraysh accustomed to what? إِلَافِهِمْ لَيْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. They are becoming accustomed to journeying in the winter and the summer. For this purpose, now it is mahzoof, understood. We granted them protection from any attack. This was from Allah. due to the house of Allah, due to Baytullah. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتُ. So in return they should worship the Lord of this house. Why have they taken these idols for worship? All their prosperity depends upon this house. This house was built by Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam for tawheed, not for shirk. Allazi atamahum min ju, that Lord of this house, he has fed them against hunger. Wa amanahum min khawf, and he has given them the security and peace from fear. Now the third. What was the moral condition of this society at that time? This is the subject matter of Surah Al-Ma'un. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ara'aita allazi yukazzibu bid-deen. Have you seen the person who denies the recompense, the judgment, the reward of the hereafter? But this was the main thing. They never said there is no Allah. They believed Allah. And they accepted that He is the creator of all the universe. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. And also about their small gods and goddesses. They never said that they are the creators or they give us the nourishment and sustenance. No. هَؤُلَاءِ سُفَعَوْنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. They are going to intercede on our behalf before our Lord. So there was a very fine demarcation. But the real thing was that they didn't believe in resurrection. That was the root cause of their decay regarding morality. أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ. Have you seen the person who denies and belies the judgment, the recompense, the requital, and the reward of the hereafter? فَذَٰلِكَ الَّذِي يَدْعُوا الْيَتِيمِ. So he is the one who repulses the orphan. Not kind to orphan. Why? Why not to eat up all the belongings and wealth of the orphan? You know, so detailed instructions given in the beginning of Surah An-Nisa about the wealth of the orphans who are under your care. If you eat anything from it, you are eating and you are putting into your stomachs life coal, burning coal, burning cinders. وَلَا يَهُوْقُ عَلَىٰ تَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينَ. And the second manifestation of their low morality, and he urges not the feeding of the poor and hungry. But to speak of feeding himself, he didn't ask anybody else also, lest he should ask him. So they were very cunning in this respect. If I say to him, okay, there are these hungry people, you feed them, he can say, why don't you do it yourself? So وَلَا يَهُوْقُ عَلَىٰ تَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينَ. You don't say anything to me, I won't say anything to you. That's the gentleman agreement between us. فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. So woe to the performers of Salah. Salah was there. Because Hajj and Salah, these two things were established by Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. They have disfigured. They have changed. Number one, the Salah, that was now a mere ritual and nothing else. No spirit. Just as we have made it a ritual. A mere ritual. رَهْ گئی رَسْمِ عَزَانْ رُوحِ بِلَالِ نَ رَهِ فَلْسَفَةَ رَهْ گِيَا تَلْقِينِ غَزَالِ نَ رَهِ. It's a ritual. Juma is a ritual. Hajj is a very big ritual. A person who goes for Hajj and comes back, no difference in his behavior or character. As he went there, in the same condition he comes back. When he went there, he was involved in riba or other things, haram shit. And when he comes back, he's starting again. So what is this Hajj? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فی ان صلاتہم ساہون، دے آر ناٹ مائنڈ فل اینڈ دے آر ہیڈ لیس آف دا اسپرٹ آف دیئر صلاح وٹ وی ہیو ڈن، بٹ ان ایڈیشن دے ہیڈ دس فکر دی صلاح آلسو، دے یوز ٹو کلیپنگ آف ہینڈس اینڈ وسلنگ ود ماؤتھس تسلیتم و موقع، سو اٹ بیکیم مور آف اے فن دین ایکچولی ورشپ. الذین ہم یراؤون، وٹ ایور ورچو واز دیر ٹو فیڈ دی ہنگری پر، فار ایگزامپل ایز آئی کوٹ اٹ ابو جہل، اف دے فیڈ دی ہنگری وی آلسو فیڈ دی ہنگری مور دین دین، بٹ دس واز ٹو شو آف، ناٹ ٹو پلیز اللہ، ناٹ ٹو ہوپ دی ریوارڈ ان دی ہیئر آفٹر، دیٹ از آؤٹ آف سائٹ آؤٹ آف مائنڈ. سو وٹ کین بی دی پرپز آف ڈوئنگ اینی تھنگ گڈ ایکسپٹ ٹو شو اٹ ٹو دی پیپل سو دیٹ دے سے او ہی از اے نوبل پرسن، نو ہی ہیز ڈن اے گڈ ڈیڈ. الذین ہم یراؤون ویمنعون المعون، اینڈ دے گو سو لو ریگارڈنگ ہیومن ریلیشنز دیٹ ریفیوز ایون اے اسمال اسسٹنس اور کائنڈنس ٹو ادرس. فار ایگزامپل یو نو ٹو بورو سم، گیو می سم سالٹ، اور کین آئی بورو دی فائر فرام یور فائر پلیس، ایون دیٹ دے ور ناٹ ریڈی ٹو ڈو فار ایچ ادر. سو دس از دی پکچر آف دیئر مورل ڈیکیڈنس. ان دس بیک گراؤنڈ ناؤ اروز دی سن آف دی میسنجر ہڈ آف محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم، سورۃ الکوثر، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، انا اعطیناک الکوثر، ویریلی شورلی او محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم وی ہیو گیون یو آل دی گڈ ان ابنڈنس. According to some traditions, this Kausar is also the name of a fountain which will be there in the plain of the gathering, Yawmul Qiyamah, and the plain of Hashr, when everybody would be very thirsty, very thirsty, very thirsty. Then this fountain of Kausar, and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would be the in charge. Whosoever from his ummah, but his ummah is the one, his ummati is the one who has followed him, followed his example practically. So their thirst will be quenched from that fountain of Kausar. Literally, and this is the saying of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that Kausar means khair-e kaseer, abundant good of every kind. Now actually, then the exfoliation of this came before the world. What Allah gave to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, nobody could even imagine in the beginning of his mission that this would come to him. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَنْحَرْ. So, O Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you pray to your Lord and offer sacrifice. This is, so to say, the picture of Eid al-Azha. We go to pray, two rakat. We remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pray to him, then come back and sacrifice the animals in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَادِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرْ. Surely it's your enemy who shall be cut off from the root. Now this abtar was a word which was used by the Arabs for a person who had no male child. Either no son was born to him, or whosoever was born died in infancy. Now they thought, when he dies, his name will die with him. No progeny. Progeny continues with the sons, not with the daughters, basically. So when two sons of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which Allah gave him through Khadija radiallahu ta'ala, when they died, so the Quraysh, the enemies, they rejoiced, especially Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. And they said, don't worry, Muhammad is abtar. He has no son now. His name will be finished. No will be there to keep his name alive. So Allah is hurling that taunt upon them. Inna shaniya kahu al-abtar. Verily, your enemies will be the ones whose name will go off. Even their own progeny will not like to mention that we are the sons of Abu Lahab. Can anybody boast? No. Surah Al-Kafirun. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ وَلَا أَنَا عَابِدٌ مَا عَبَدْتُمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينِ. It is very important. And it must have been revealed. It is a Meccan surah, no doubt. But it must have been revealed at the end of the Makki period. When after 12 years long, you know, admonition and da'wah and preaching and teaching proved to be of no avail to the majority of the people of Quraysh at Makkah. Now it was sort of a parting of ways. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. This is the only surah, only place in Quran where يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ we have in Surah Zumar. قُلْ أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَعْمُرُونِ أَعْبُدُ أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ. But that's only one place. And this is only place. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. Oh, you kafirs. Otherwise, Quran says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, يَا أَيُّهَا. Oh, people, oh, mankind. Because Dawa needs this type of address. But this surah is not from Dawa. It is, so to say, saying that the Dawa is finished now. Bygone. Say, oh, the disbelievers, لَا عَبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ. I don't worship whom you worship. وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَبِدُونَ مَا عَبُدُونَ. Nor you worship whom I worship. What's in the between the lines? Actually, the mushrikeen, they said, we also worship Allah. Allah is common between you and us. Allah says to Muhammad, tell them, you are not worshipping Allah. Because Allah is the one who has no associate whatsoever with him. So you have created an Allah of your own thought, your own imagination. You are not worshipping the Allah whom I am worshipping. Name might be the same, but Musamma, to whom that name is being given, absolutely different in my mind and your mind. وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُ وَلَا أَنَا عَابِدٌ مَا عَبَدْتُمْ. And I am not going to, this is the final, I am never going to worship whom you are worshipping. وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا عَبُدْتُمْ. Nor are you going to worship whom I am worshipping. لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينَ. But you is your deen. For me is my deen. So it's a parting of ways. Go you your way, I am going my way. Maybe I am going to Medina. Okay. Surah An-Nasr. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. When the help from Allah comes and victory kisses your feet. Most of the people think that this surah is Madaniyah and it was revealed after the victory had come. Actually, in that case, it should have been Izja. It is Izaja. Izza refers to the future. It was a prophecy, actually. And this is Makki surah, according to me. All the surahs we are reading from Suratul Mulk up till now, they're all Makki, no Madani surah. According to my opinion, only the Muawwazatain are the two Madani surahs that come at the end. Otherwise, all these surahs are Makki. So it was said there as a prophecy. that, oh Muhammad, the time will come. You are facing hardships, no doubt. You are seeing no way. But a time will come. When that time comes and the help of Allah arrives and victory comes to you, it kisses your feet. وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. And you see people entering the deen of Allah in multitudes. Now what is deen of Allah? The system of life where Allah is supreme. This is deen of Allah. We have in Surah Yusuf, deen al-Malik. مَا كَانَ لَيَأْخُذَ أَخَاهُ فِي دِينِ الْمَلِكِ. Hazrat Yusuf could not detain with him his brother Binyamin, according to the law of the king. Yusuf alayhi salam was not the king. The king was the one who saw that dream. And because Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam gave an interpretation of that dream, so he rose to that position, a very high position. He was a very big officer, so to say, maybe finance minister, maybe food minister, maybe agriculture minister, sort of that thing, but not king. So he was under the rule of the king, Deen al-Malik. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had to devise, you know, a special thing for him, so that he could detain or retain his brother with him. So when, you know, a king is accepted as monarch, as Fir'aun, you know, said, أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرُ وَهَذِهِ الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي. Is not the kingdom of Egypt from me? I am the king. And all these irrigation channels are under my control. So this is the deen of king, deenul malik. And deen of Allah, obedience to Allah, whole life under this obedience to Allah. Now somebody is entering this deen of Allah, it's not necessary that he has iman also. He has accepted the obedience. So he is in the deen of Allah. Do you follow what I'm saying? He has accepted the citizenship of this Islamic state. We don't know whether he has iman or not. Some of you must have recalled that ayah number 14 of Surah Al-Hujurat. قَالَتِ الْعَرَابُ آمَنَّا قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَكِنْ قُلُوا أَسْلَمْنَا وَلَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. These Bedouins are claiming, we have come to believe. Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have not at all come to believe. All you may say is, you have surrendered, you have submitted, you have accepted the supremacy of the law of Allah and the deen of Allah. So when that victory will come, and you will see people entering the deen of Allah, accepting the supremacy of the divine rule, in multitudes. فَصَبِّ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْهُ. Then at that time, you should glorify your Lord with His praise and also ask for His forgiveness. الرَّبُّ رَبٌّ وَإِنْ تَنَزَّلْ وَالْعَبْدُ عَبْدٌ وَإِنْ تَرَقَّى. A servant or a bondsman is a servant, howsoever high he might rise. And Allah is the Lord, howsoever low he might come. He comes to the first heaven every night. Muhammad went to the seventh heaven on the night of Miraj, Ascension. But even there, Muhammad was Abd. And Allah was Lord. So having reached that position also, never think that you will be very absolutely free from any shortcoming. Shortcoming may abide be there. But we cannot have this on the analogy of our shortcomings. This word of Zamb has also come in Surah Muhammad, Zamba, and Surah Fatah. But you know, our sin and Huzur, this sin of Muhammad, absolutely different. There's the hadith, Prophet says, إِنَّهُ لَيُغَانُ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِي. Verily, on my heart also, sometimes I feel there is some curtain has come. وَإِنِّي لَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ سَبْعِينَ مَرَّةً فِي كُلِّ يَوْمٍ. And we apologize to Allah. And I ask for his forgiveness 70 times every day. But what was that sin? A slight diminution in the intensity of relationship. This depends upon the how sensitive you are to these things. So for this you ask the forgiveness. Surely, indahu kānata vāba, he is ever relenting, always ready to accept the repentance from his servants. Now this surah, I think, should be read with Suratul Inshirah. Today we began with that surah. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ is here. When the deen of Allah will become supreme in the Arabian Peninsula, your work will be done. Why we sent you for that purpose? هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى والدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. When the deen has become dominant, now your mission is accomplished. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. Now you meditate to your Lord, devote wholly and solely, you know, to Him. The same thing here. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْهُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. Suratul Lahab. Again something concerning the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Lahab was the uncle. And Umme Jameel, his wife, both were the worst enemies of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't have any brother. Nor he ever saw his father. But he has uncles. Now we see how varied. About four we know. One loved him, protected him, but didn't believe in him. One believed him and loved him, but after 6 years. The third one also finally came to believe in him. But he never played any prominent role in the struggle. So much so that up till Badr, he had not declared that he is mu'min. And he came to Badr along with the army of Kuffar. But the Prophet knew that he is a mu'min. And the fourth one is Abu Lahab, the worst enemy. And as I told you, the worst character. The best character of that time, Abu Bakr, Atqa. And the worst character of that time was this Abu Lahab. And this incident happened when the command came to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Fasda bima tumar. This ayah is included in the last portion of Suratul Hijr. Now say loudly, O Muhammad, what had been commanded to you, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now we ascended the hillock of Safa. And he raised a cry, Wa sabaha! This was the custom of the Arabs. If some news came to you that such and such tribe is planning to attack you, this night they will attack you. Now you want that this news should reach all the people immediately, so that they can take the precautionary steps, whatever they can take. So what did he used to do? Take off all his clothings, absolute naked, ascended some high place, and then cried out, Wa sabaha! Woe to the morning that is coming. A very bad morning is coming. Now two things happened. Where his voice reached, people heard this. Where the voice was not reaching, people saw a naked man standing on their own. And they called it Nazir-e-Uriyan, the warner, the naked warner. Now here's the lesson for us. If you have to make dawah, you see, what are the means available today? Whatever is haram in it, delete. Whatever is permissible, you have to use. If you don't use, then you are to blame. So when Muhammad ascended, and Wa sabaha, he cried, people ran to him. But then I can't go into detail. When he presented his message, the first response was from Abu Lahab. Tabban laka lihaza jama'atana. Woe to you. Perish you. Did you call us for this thing? We thought there is some danger. You have got some news. You want to warn us from some possible attack of any tribe. So in response, this surah was revealed. Tabbat yada abi lahab wa tab. Actually, the both hands of Abu Lahab have perished. The hands of Muhammad are not going to perish. And wa tab, and he himself has been perished. Maagna anhu maluhu wa maakasab. His wealth will not avail him, nor what he earned. He met a very, very sad end. He couldn't go to Badr. He was coward also. I said, worst character. And because he was the custodian of the treasurer of Kaaba, so he was the minister of finance, so to say, of their government at Makkah. And he has stolen, people used to say that he has stolen a golden, you know, calf from that, the treasurer. So that was the name that was given to him, the stealer of the calf. So he didn't have any good reputation whatsoever. مَا أَغْنَىٰ عَنْهُ مَالُهُ وَمَا كَسَبْ. His wealth is not going to avail him. But what happened? In Badr also he sent a person, you know, mercenary, paid him. Go in my place. He couldn't go. Then this person was so rash against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Two of the daughters of the Prophet were engaged to two of his sons. He said, go and give talaq to those, both of them. In the open, address Muhammad and say, we give talaq to your daughters. And they did it in the open. And this was a very big humiliation. Both later on died. The Prophet prayed against them. For one who was more vocal, the Prophet said, oh Allah, let loose on him one of your dogs. He was coming back from Syria, leading a caravan during the night. They were staying somewhere. And he knew that Muhammad has prayed this thing against him. So he used to have, you know, fire around him where he rested during the night. But a tiger came, jumped over that fire, ate him up, went back. Sayasla naran zata lahab. Then, you know, he also died. Pustules appeared over the whole of his body. And then, you know, there was bad smell coming out. And there were, you know, the organisms in those wounds moving. So nobody from his family could go near him. And then when he died, nobody was ready to touch him. With the help of a wood, they dug a grave and then, you know, just pushed him by this wood, not touching him. This was the end. تَبَّتْ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبَّ مَا أَغْنَىٰ عَنْهُ مَالُهُ وَمَا كَسَبْ سَيَصْلَىٰ نَارًا ذَاتَ لَهَبٍ. He will enter the war of fire which is flaming. وَمْرَاتُهُ. Not only he, also his wife. حَمَّالَةَ الْحَطَبِ. The carrier of firewood. فِي جِيدِهَا حَبْلٌ مِّن مَّسَدْ. Upon her neck a rope of palm fibers will be there. Now she was a very rich lady. She used to have a very fine and costly necklace around her neck. But in the hereafter, this necklace will take the form of a rope of the fibers of date palm tree. And with that, it will bring, you know, fuel and add to the fire of her husband, adding fuel. Because, you know, wives, either they support you in your deen or they oppose you. And if they are also on the wrong path, they are supporting the wrong path. In the same way, she will be kindling the fire of hell for her husband. Suratul Ikhlas, the surah about which the Prophet has said, it's equal to one-third of the whole Quran. ثلث القرآن، دی موسٹ پروفاؤنڈ سورہ آن دی سبجیکٹ آف توحید، بٹ توحید فی العقیدہ اینڈ توحید فی الذات ان دی پرسن، بٹ آیت الکرسی از دی موسٹ پروفاؤنڈ ان دی توحید فی الصفات ایٹریبیوٹس آف اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی، توحید فی الصفات ہائیسٹ پریئر، دی بگیسٹ پریئر از آیت الکرسی، توحید فی الذات دی بگیسٹ پریئر از دس سورۃ الاخلاص. قل هو الله احد، سے ہی از اللہ، دی اونلی ون، رادر دی الون، نن ود ہم، نن لائک ہم، نو پارٹنر ود ہم، اللہ الصمد، آل ایٹرنلی آسک ہم، بیسیچ ہم، ہی از دی بیسارٹ آف آل. وی ہیو ریڈ دی آیا ان سورۃ الرحمن، یس الوہ من فی السماوات و من فی الارض، ایوری ون ہو از ان دی ہیونز اور ان دی ارتھ کیپ آن آسکنگ اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی، ہی ڈزنٹ نیڈ اینی ون، بٹ ایوری بڈی ایوری تھنگ نیڈس ہم. لم یلد ولم یولد، نائدر ہی بگیٹ نور ہی واز بگاٹن، نو فادر اور مدر، نو سن اور ڈاٹر واٹس سو ایور. ولم یکن لہ کفواً احد، اینڈ دیر از نن کو ایکول وتھ ہم اور کمپیریبل ٹو ہم. ان دی اینڈ وی ہیو ٹو سینٹینلز گارڈنگ دس قرآن، المعوذتین، ویری ویری بیوٹیفل یو نو پیئر آف سوراس. اینڈ دیر از این اوپینئن آف عبداللہ ابن مسعود دیٹ ایکچولی دیز سوراز آر ناٹ پارٹ آف قرآن، دے ور ریویلڈ فار ٹریٹنگ محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم وین سم جیو ہیڈ ڈن سم سورسری اگینسٹ ہم، بٹ دی کنسنسس آف دی اما از دیٹ دے آر اے پارٹ اینڈ پارسل آف قرآن. اینڈ مائی اوپینئن دیز ٹو سوراز آر اونلی دی مدنی سوراز ان دس لاسٹ گروپ آف مکی مدنی سوراز. ان دی فرسٹ سورا اونلی ون سورا واز مکی، دیٹ از سورۃ الفاتحہ اینڈ البقرہ، آل عمران، النساء، المائدہ، مدنیات. دس از دی کانورس فرام سورۃ الملک ٹو سورۃ اخلاص، آل مکیات، نن مدنی، اینڈ دیز ٹو آر مدنی. قل اعوذ برب الفلق، سے آئی سیک ریفیوج ود دی لارڈ آف دی ڈان، من شر ما خلق، فرام آل دی ایون آف آل دیٹ ہی ہیز کریٹڈ. دس از ویری نوٹ وردی، وٹ ایور از کریٹڈ از ڈیفینیٹلی انکمپلیٹ، کمپلیشن از اونلی فار اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی. آل کریشن has to be incomplete from one aspect or the other, and this aspect of incompletion adds to it some sort of shar, some sort of evil. So I take refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of everything that he has created. وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وقب، and from the evil of the darkness when it overspreads, because you know in the night the criminals are active and so on, the jinns also, the evil spirits as you call them. وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ، and from the evil of the blowers at the knocks, knots, sorcerers, magicians. وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ، and from the evil of an envier, a jealous person, when his malignant envy is carried out in action. Hasidin is a hasada, when he is actively engaged in bringing his jealousy into action, translating it into practice. So these are the evils which befall human beings from without, outside. Now there is a very big evil which comes from within, and that is the subject of the last surah. سورة الناس بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. قل اعوذ برب الناس ملک الناس الہ الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذی یوسوس فی صدور الناس من الجنۃ والناس سے آئی سیک ریفیوج فرام دی لارڈ آف مین کائنڈ. ناؤ دس لارڈ یو نو از دی ٹرانسلیشن آف رب. وٹ از رب؟ دی اونر، دی سسٹینر، دی پرووائڈر، دی ڈیولپر، آل دیز تھنگز گو ٹو میک رب. اللہ از دی لارڈ اور رب آف دی مین کائنڈ. ملک الناس، ہی از دا کنگ آف آل مین کائنڈ، سوورن، ہی از ٹو بی اوبیڈ، ہز لاز آر ٹو بی انفورسڈ، ہز اوبیڈینس از ٹو بی ایکسپٹڈ. الہ الناس اینڈ دی گاڈ آف مین کائنڈ، گاڈ ٹو ہوم یو کال فار ہیلپ، for any deliverance from any affliction which has come to you, to whom you pray, and whosoever grants your prayers is your God. Ilah. So, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ. These are the three attributes, we may say, of Allah. If you remember, these are the same which are mentioned in Surah Al-Fatiha. الحمد للہ رب العالمین، الرحمن الرحیم مالک یوم الدین اور ملک یوم الدین. ایاک نعبد معبود الہ، دیز تھری تھنگز. من شر الوسواس الخناس، فرام دی ایول آف دی وسپرر ہو وسپرز ان دی ہارٹس آف دی پیپل اینڈ دین ریسیڈز اینڈ وڈراز گوز بیک. من الجنۃ والناس، ویدر ہی بی فرام امنگ دی جن اور مین کائنڈ. ناؤ دس از این اٹیک تھرو یور اون بیسر سیلف، ناٹ آؤٹ سائڈ، نتھنگ از اٹیکنگ یو فرام آؤٹ سائڈ. یور اون اڈ اور لیبیڈو، یور اون بیسر سیلف از ایکٹیویٹڈ. سو ناؤ دی شر از کمنگ فرام ود ان یو، آل دو دس فائر از اگنائٹڈ بائی ہم ہو از وسپرنگ ان یو. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of this Quran and the courage to resolve that we should practice it, propagate it, and establish it, in the world. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen.
Allahu Akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us Together, we can make a difference.